Okay, this is Princess Cove, and it's Sunday. I believe it's May 21st or 22nd. Anyway, we're going to check out a new launch ramp. It's about 5 miles north of Catherine's Landing, Lake Mohave. Okay, the boat's fully prepped. Got the plug in the boat, very important. Back there, check. And the boat is unstrapped, and we're gonna launch it at Princess Cove. Laurie's back in the boat down. It's very steep here, but we have four-wheel drive and she's really good at backing down, so okay, start. It's a steep ramp, no doubt about it. Okay, she's properly lining up now. Looking good. Okay, this is the launch ramp. It's very steep and it's kind of a long walk downhill. We found camp about probably 15 miles up. It's the same place we saw about 3.5-4 weeks ago. Just a great beach. It's really flat, just crystal clear water, as you can see. And we have some nice neighbors with two daughters, a real nice 24-foot boat, it looks like. They're day campers. Thank you. Well, when we came into camp, it was pretty windy, and the formations of white caps out there, and it's really laid down. And we got our trusty Weber barbecue here. We're gonna barbecue some chicken. Beautiful night. Okay, so we're gonna go cheers. This is our campsite. We have a beach all to our own. Yesterday there was a day camper, a family out of Covina, California. But as you can see, there's a lot of real estate here. Great place, one of the best beaches we've ever had in the 35 years we've been boating out at the Lake Mead recreational area, which includes Lake Mohave. This is Monday, May 22nd. We're about ready to just go exploring. We're probably gonna eat an early lunch and have a Bloody Mary. Last night we had probably coyotes raid our campsites, and there wasn't a trace of our trash. We had chicken last night and there was no evidence of the chicken bones or anything else. When we came in last night, it was pretty windy, so we put a second rope out here because the wind comes from the south. So this is looking south down here, and there was a south wind blowing, so we put a diagonal line out just for stability and keeping that anchor tight and not putting too much stress on the anchor. So we found out through experience by staking up another line that goes diagonally, really helps in case of a high wind. And oddly enough, about an hour after we got back here, it was completely calm, and what a beautiful night we had last night. It was great. And we're about ready to pick up camp. Gonna beach it here a little bit south of Catherine's Landing for lunch, and then continue on down a couple miles to Davis Dam. As long as the shore is rock free, for the most part, we'll nose the boat in to a sandy shore. I see a little pebbles, but I don't think overall it's going to hurt the front end of the boat. And the out drive's coming up, but it's plenty deep here. We are doing a lunch stop here at Davis Cove, and it's a pretty nice place. We're about a mile south of Catherine's Landing, and there's a lot of sandy beaches here. We're here a weekend before Memorial Weekend, and I'll tell you what, in this area here, it's going to be wall-to-wall boats and party people. There's going to probably be, in this strip here, there's probably going to be 10 boats, just neck, side to side, just right next to each other. It's going to be pretty crazy Memorial Weekend, and the Rangers and the cops are going to be out here in force. There's really a zero tolerance as far as alcohol and driving. Alright, this is Davis Dam. This releases water into the Needles area and then continues to flow to Lake Havasu. So there's only one more dam below this, and that is Parker Dam. And once the water leaves Parker Dam, it goes through the Colorado River system for irrigation, and then it goes into the Gulf of Mexico through California area. So is that a no-entry buoy or a wakeless speed buoy, Laurie?
Flat wake.
Okay. I'm sure prior to 9/11 you could boat right up to that dam, but after 9/11 security got really, really tight at Hoover Dam and Davis Dam, all of the dams on the Colorado River. The security was taken very seriously after 9/11. Thank you. So this is referred to as Gasoline Alley by the locals. See the holes in the rocks, Laurie?
Yeah.
And we're still at about 35 feet. So we're looking pretty good. Look at that big barrel cactus way up there.
Yep.
All right, we're nearing the end, but it's still 42 feet. So we're looking pretty good. It's really nice back here. This is referred to as Gasoline Alley by the locals. Oop, I gotta change gas tanks once we get out there, okay? Alright, this is at the end of the line. We're gonna make a U-turn, go back out, and we have to switch the tanks. We manually switch the valves on the tanks every hour to keep the boat in balance and not listing from one side to another, so we try to burn fuel evenly. It's a beautiful cove. There's a better beach here. So this is on the actual south side of that cove, and the American flag is up there. I bet somebody marked this campsite for holiday weekend guys that are coming up next weekend for Memorial Weekend. This is a nice beach. And in fact, it's so nice, Laurie and I are gonna actually stop and check it out. Check it out. Laurie and I are actually going to nose into the beach here where the American flag is standing proudly on top of the ridge. 9 times out of 10, I bet you that was set by a veteran or a family of a vet, I'm guessing. 9 feet. Sand, no rocks. I'm still going to proceed with a little caution. Wow, very cool. I am checking out the bottom, and the bottom looks good. And I'm getting some depth sounds on our GPS saying we're in shallow water. Perfect. Somebody built a sandcastle, so there is probably a family here earlier this weekend. Great beach. In fact, the sand is perfect and the water is crystal clear. As far as protection, yeah, this is not a bad place to be. It's protected from both north and south winds, so I'm liking this. I mean, there's not much of a beach from the water line, but with minimal camping gear that we do bring, we could make this work pretty well. This beach is directly across Mohave Cove. I just looked at the map, and this is actually one large cove north of Rattlesnake Cove, which Rattlesnake Cove would be towards the south, and it would be one major cove over. Hard-packed sand, clear, clean water, no rocks on the beach that I can see. Laurie and I came back to Flag Cove. So the cove that has the US flag, we came back to because Cove is gonna give us early shade. So what we decided to do is we came back to Flag Cove. I named it Flag Cove because I really don't know the name of the cove, but it's one cove up from Rattlesnake Cove. And we are on the west side of the lake. And we found this terrific beach. But the absolute cool part is right up above, there is an American flag with a POW MIA insignia right in the middle. Very unique because it's a combined flag. I love it. What we're looking at is an American flag about one cove up north of Rattlesnake Cove on Lake Mohave. It's real cool because it has a POW MIA insignia right in the middle, and it's right above a cool cove. Great sandy beach. Laurie and I got early shade in this cove, and we're gonna hang here for about probably another hour before we go back to our camp. Our camp doesn't have any shade, so. This is a great tribute for the Memorial Weekend that's coming up next weekend. And this lake's gonna be pretty popular and pretty active. Right now it's a Monday evening. We're waiting for the sun to go down on the other side so that Laurie and I could haul ass back to our camp. Our camp is probably it's pretty close, maybe 2 miles south of here. And we're having steaks tonight, so that's gonna be a quick cook. There was absolutely stunning cloud formations today. It was really cool to just observe the way they were heading, the direction that they were heading, and the speed that they were heading. It's really great, but the wind looked like it was traveling north, which which is the way we're panning now, and then all of a sudden the clouds just ended up stopping. We're getting ready for dinner. We just got back at about sundown. We found a beautiful beach, and it's really great. It's probably 93 to 95 right now. It's just perfect. It's not hot. We're gonna have a great night's sleep. We're gonna have steaks tonight. This is our camp. Did you already pour a glass of wine?
Well, we have our
okay. So it's about 7:30 right now. Our last night, sunset. We just put the potatoes on. This boat was made in April of 1988, and it's held up really well. We've actually gone through three tow vehicles, and this thing has just been bulletproof. Laurie just said we have waterfront property. We can't afford it in Orange County, but we can afford it up here. Basically. Now we spend the night out here. Last night it was a great night. It wasn't hot or cold. We just put a sheet over us. Tonight we're expecting the same thing. We're picking up camp. Most of the camping gear is already loaded on the boat. That's all we have left, and then we have to get our anchor lines up. Here's where our barbecue goes, on the port side of the boat. And we have our bags of charcoal briquettes. On the starboard side is where we keep our folding chairs. We have a real nice set of four folding chairs that fold down very flat, and they're stowed in that little well right there. And we have our anchor ropes and lines down here. We have a twin battery configuration. And then back here, if you can see it, we have manual fuel tank selector valves. Before we had electric switching, but that gave out and it was too expensive to put it back in. So we have to every hour switch the valves so I can keep the boat balanced. So I run 1 hour on one side, 1 hour on the other side.